Hello viewers, welcome to this session. I am going to talk about Aristotle's Poetics summary. Aristotle's Poetics is a landmark book on literary criticism. This book contains 26 chapters. Some of the portion of this book is missing. However, Aristotle talks about important aspects of poetry, drama, tragedy, comedy, etc. in Poetics. Now let me talk about the summary, the sum and substance of the book in brief. Aristotle deals with different types of poetry in the beginning of his treatise, Poetics. According to Aristotle, there are different kinds of poetry, such as epic poetry, lyric, etc. Aristotle says that epic poetry is a great poetry. It is superior to any other poetry. Then Aristotle talks about drama. He says that tragedy is superior to comedy. Tragedy, defining tragedy, he says that tragedy represents a life. It produces effect that creates catharsis, leading to pity and fear. This is the concept of tragedy of Aristotle. Now let me talk about the things in detail. Aristotle says that a tragedy is superior to comedy. A tragedy deals with a noble man, whereas a comedy deals with a man with weaknesses, with greed, with lust for money, wealth, sex, etc. So Aristotle distinguishes tragedy from comedy. Further, Aristotle says that there are six essential parts of tragedy. What are these essential parts of tragedy? These essential parts of tragedy are: number one, plot; number two, character; number three, diction; number four, thought; number five, melody or song; number six, spectacles. Now let me discuss each of them in brief. Plot is the soul of tragedy. Plot refers to arrangement of all the events in such a way that it has unity among them. Plot is very important thing in tragedy. Plot refers to the series of events that take place in a tragedy. The series of events are is arranged in such a way that it has organic whole, organic unity. So plot is very important constituent or part of tragedy. The second important thing is character. A tragic character has nobility. He is a noble man. He is a towering personality. He is either a king or a lord or a general of army. Character has ideals. He is a man of thoughts and actions. He has a hemesia, defects, shortcomings that leads him to tragedy. And his fall from the high position to low creates pity and fear in the minds of audience. The third important thing is diction. Diction is important part of tragedy. Diction means use of the language, the use of the terms, the use of the phrases and phraseology. A tragedy should have high sounding phrases. A tragedy should have fine diction. Only then a tragedy becomes successful. The next important thing is thought. A tragedy must have grandeur thought. If the thought is grandeur, the tragedy, the play will be grandeur. So a thought must be noble. The thought must suit the tragic hero. The next is melody or song. There is melody or song in a tragedy, and this melody and song releases the tension of the tragedy or tragic play from time to time. And last but not least is the spectacle. A spectacle refers to the description of scenes and sights. A tragedy must present a striking scene, a beautiful scene, so that it may have distinction from other genre of literature, say comedy. Thus, Aristotle talks about these six constituents of tragedy. Then Aristotle says that tragedy was considered or meant for inferior audience, and comedy was meant for higher class of audience. But Aristotle is of the view that tragedy is a higher kind of play, higher kind of drama. It is superior to comedy. A tragedy deals with noble actions, noble thoughts, but a comedy deals with the great weaknesses of the characters of the hero. Aristotle deals with all these things in his book Poetics. Now for details you can go on description. Thanks a lot.